Hello, this is Mark from the Photomatix team. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up automatic exposure bracketing on a Sony A7 IV. This will let you take three or more photographs, each at a different exposure, when you press the shutter button. Switch the camera on and locate the mode dial, which is on the top right of the camera. Turn the mode dial so that M, for manual, lines up with the white marker. Make sure the lower dial is set to the photo camera icon. If it isn't, press and hold its lock release button and turn the dial counterclockwise until it is. On the right-hand side is the function button labeled FN. Press it to open the function menu containing frequently used functions. You might see a different setting highlighted from what's showing. Above the function button is the multi-selector, which is used to navigate through the menu. Move through the settings with the multi-selector until the drive mode setting at the far left is highlighted. I'll need to move left 3 times to get there. To quickly change a setting in this menu, you'll find 2 more dials on top of the camera. Use the front dial to choose which function to change, and the rear left dial to set it to the value you want. Turn the front dial 4 ticks clockwise until BRK C is showing, which stands for continuous bracketing. Use the left rear dial to adjust the bracketing settings. Turn it clockwise until you see 2.0 EV3 highlighted on the second row. What you've chosen is to take 3 images, 2 exposure values apart. One photo, 2 EV underexposed, one photo at normal exposure, and one photo at 2 EV overexposed. Press the function button once to save the setting and return to the shooting screen. You have now activated automatic exposure bracketing on your Sony A7 IV. All you need to do now is to keep the camera still, press and hold down the shutter button until all the photos are taken. Once you've taken the bracketed photos, you can merge them to HDR in Photomatix. You can see how to do that by watching this video next. Or you can download Photomatix Pro with the button to the right or in the video's description. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below.